Him plainly. When you look upon my form, what do you see? A monster? A temple? He would not answer. Look deeper, I said, for I am not the masks I wear. In this, Sauron and I are the same.
Not the masks she wears. Remember this, Talion.
The wicked world of men burn.
Just hear something.
A killer's about.
Each city in Gondor administers its own justice in all but the most important cases. And in my lifetime, we've always handled legal matters in Minas Ithil. When I was a girl, I recall my father being much occupied with mercantile disputes and other legal affairs. Then the orcs came, and matters of justice yielded to matters of survival.
Chiefs!
The Gaveler. Always seemed an odd symbol for justice.
What is justice, if not a hammer to beat down the proud nail?
Get that firelit! An entrance!
Something just moved!
Gondorians. Well, he wants to win.
Gondor has faced the Witch King before, and he's had a vendetta against Minas Ithil ever since. This coin depicts the victor, Aenor, last king of Gondor. Generations ago, Aenor led an army that routed the Witch King and sent his army fleeing to Angmar. But our victory turned hollow when our king grew prideful. The Witch King challenged Aenor to single combat, and Aenor rode eastward from Minas Tirith, never to be seen again. It takes a nation to defeat such evil, not just one man.
He's welcome to the tile.
Aenor, he who fought the Witch King twice, because he did not finish the task the first time.
It is time to spread the corruption!
You got a lot of nerve, I'll give you that. Too bad nerve just gets you into fights. It don't get you out of them.
Will rise a billowing stench so powerful, you will never escape it!
What was that supposed to be?
Obsessed with rings, more so than coins or jewelry of equal value. They snatch them from prisoners immediately, and what happens to these rings is anyone's guess. We rarely find orcs actually wearing them.
A fine ring. But I gather it's an ordinary one.
Ha! Scarcely worth the same name as the ring we created.
The Red Arrow is one of Gondor's most treasured symbols, though few know just what it symbolizes. When our need is dire, we can present the arrow to the men of Rohan, and they are bound by ancient pact to ride to our aid. We should have used it in the early days of the siege, but the orcs encircled us so quickly, and Rohan is too far away.
I wonder whether Rohan would honor this arrow if they saw it.
Difficult to say. Men have short memories. And shorter still in a crisis.
The Ranger! I smell something.
You think I don't see what you're up to? I see in ways you can't even imagine. My eye pierces earth and shadow, and my arrow shall pierce flesh and sinew.
Tremble before me!
speak it.
Take that!
Nicely done!
Gondorian folktales abound with drakes, lesser versions of the great dragons who supposedly slumber under the earth. Yet here in Mordor, I've seen them with my own eyes, though from a safe distance, and they are nothing like the storybooks say. They are lethal hunters of the air, rapacious and cruel, apt to torment their prey before eating it. This scale, taken from a drake carcass we found in a Graug cave, gives some sense of their size, and how strong they must be to carry such weight aloft.
Die, weak!
Scale of a drake or a full-fledged dragon?
Certainly a drake. Dragons take better care of their scales.
We Gondorians called Minas Ithil home. But we cannot claim to have built it. That honor belongs to exiles from the fabled realm of Numenor beyond the Sundering Seas. Wondrous architects, they fashioned this city of marble to reflect the moonlight and glow with an inner warmth. But the city's beauty and light drew the ire of the Witch King, who has long sought revenge on Gondor.
The Numenorians' knack for towers rivals the elves.
Who do you think taught them? They were but precocious students.
Elves have mundane objects as we do, for even their common containers and vessels seem uncommonly fine. This artifact was once part of a table setting given as a gift centuries ago. The other parts were broken when one of Mordor's many ground tremors knocked them off a shelf. How I wish my predecessors had saved the broken shards. That's a puzzle I'd like to reassemble. Elven things deserve to last.
What sort of feasts do the elves have?
Stately affairs, not as raucous as orcs or men.
Is purported to be the creation of hobbits, a sort of halfling that lives beyond our reckoning in the north. I wonder at the strange notion of full-grown adults who scarcely reach my waist in height. But after what I've seen in Mordor, a hobbit would be a welcome sort of strange. Though I don't think a hobbit would last long in Mordor.
Now all I need is some pipeweed.
Which you won't find for leagues in any direction.
In the Great Hall of Minas Ithil, we didn't just safeguard the treasures of our past. We kept our present there as well. An archive of all our official correspondence with the capital. I used to file away missives from Minas Tirith after my father had read them. This was a weekly task at first, but as our surroundings grew more dangerous, scrolls like this one became more rare. I wonder whether there were promises of aid that the orcs intercepted. Plans for relief that we never saw.
Workings of government reduced to parchment.
Minas Ithil didn't need parchment. It needed reinforcements.
When Aenar didn't return from his confrontation with the Witch King, word of his fall spread like wildfire across Gondor. The Witch King's forces were regrouping, rapidly seizing lands once under Aenar's rule. Some regions fell so quickly that letters sent by the first ruling steward of Gondor, Mardil, never reached their destinations. For generations, we stored the unread letters here, destined to remain forever sealed. We know those lost Gondorians will never claim their letters, but we keep them to honor their memory. I wonder what will become of the last few letters I sent on my father's behalf.
I can show you how to conquer Mordor.
As long as it keeps Gondor safe, no need. I know the heart of my people, so I know what they say.
You reckon the Witch King?
glory, Aglar. In those days, our triumphs on the battlefield were many. Mordor was ours to claim. Battlefield glories made me believe we were invincible, but they blinded me to the true danger, Sauron plotting in the shadows. Now I shall wield the light and burn the shadows from Mordor.